Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Gavinski's Tutorials. Today I'm going to do a walkthrough of the new app by Mikhail Matsura, I think. Now finally I got the pronunciation of that name. So also known as Sqsul, S-E-Q-S-U-A-L, or S-Q-S-L. This app is called Nashville, obviously after the Nashville numbers system. So this is basically a MIDI chord generator app. So here I'm sending MIDI from that into AUM. So this app is a standalone app, Nashville, right? Standalone. But we can send that MIDI out into other apps. Now, Nashville runs on iPad and M1 Max. I think you can check the details in the App Store. So here I'm using it to play all four of these different instruments. El piano, swam double bass pizzicato mode, pure strings by E Instruments, and Beep Street Xeon. So you can see if you look down here, you know, you see these are being triggered at different times. That's something that we can set up in the setup section of the app here, which I'll look at later. Basically, the way it's set up at the moment, it's gonna randomly send notes to these four channels. So we're not getting all of those instruments playing at the same time. Also note that here I've put on apply random note delay. If I turn that off, then we're just getting chords. I'll demo that later with just one instrument. It'll be a bit clearer. Maybe I'll do that now, actually. Let's do that. So if you see now I've set it, all the notes are just going to MIDI channel 1. And I've set this to receive on MIDI channel 1. The way I've set this session up, I've set this to receive on MIDI channel 1. Okay. And this receive on 2, this receive on 3, this receive on 4. So if you're sending this to another app, just make sure that the MIDI output here, you know, we have a few different options, right, that we can select depending on what, you know, what the system sees as destinations that you could send that to. And then just in here, just make sure that you're receiving it from whatever that's, whatever Nashville is sending out on. So here, Sqsl Nashville. Yes, Sqsl Nashville, right. So I'll, in this video, I will explain how this app works and I'll make some suggestions for improvements as well. So I'll do a review. I've been really enjoying this, but definitely there's a few things that are missing that I think it could benefit from. So let me explain the basic concept. So over here, now this is only set to deal with heptatonic modes. So there's no pentatonic or anything here. Everything is going to be scales or modes with 7 notes in them. And that's basically because of the limitation imposed by the UI. I suppose it could be redone in a way that it would be flexible. I don't know. It would probably be a major headache. But that gives you absolutely tons of options. So if you look here on the left, you pick a scale pattern, right? So here we've chosen diatonic. And then over here on the right, we have the modes associated with diatonic. So that's all your typical modes, right? If I click on the next one here, melodic, now you can see we have a bunch of different modes available. And you can see also that it's already changed the flavor of everything. So the basic idea of this app is that you can use these pads to play chords and adjusting things up here and over here and here and here. And we'll talk about all those sections later. You can immediately get your progression sounding completely different. So an interesting composition tool, maybe a way to learn about music theory and stuff. And just, you know, very, very quickly set something up that you can send out to synths and then go and tweak those synths, for example. So if I click on harmonic major, now you see the modes over here. So it's currently on this Ionian flat 6. here we could change to this Dorian mode here, or now this Phrygian one, and so on. Okay, so you get the idea. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times 7. So we've got 45 different modes there. So it's quite a lot, even if you don't have pentatonic or whatever. So let me just turn play off here. I'm going to turn evolve off as well. And we'll look at how things work here. So here is where we can set the root note. Which notes are going to be played, you know, what things will be quantized to will be set by whatever mode is selected here. So C Ionian has these notes, C, D, E, F, G, A, B. Okay, it's basically C major scale. So here we can set four different chord shapes. I think that's a bit low. I'd like to see at least 8 there, really. I'll mention that and other suggestions for improvement later. But the basic idea here is this. Let's say I take this pad here. I've set this up so that this is just going to play, it's going to play a C, okay, the first degree here. So this is the first degree, second degree, third degree, fourth degree, fifth degree, and so on. So this pad, when I have this pad set like this, if I play this, for example, it's going to play a C, okay, and then the third degree, so that's an E, and then a G, the fifth degree. So we're going to get C, E, G. And if I do this, that's going to be up an octave. Now it's down an octave, now it's down another octave, right? But now, I could also change the voicing of that. Like I could put this like that, for example. Okay, or I could put it like that. Okay, and of course I can have, you know, as many notes in there as I want. And I could also just play around with adjusting all this in real time. You know, you don't have to record anything if you don't want to. But let's just go back to this. So here, okay, we got C, E, and a G. Okay, 1, 3, and 5 from these options. 1, 3, 4, 5, okay? So if I play here, now we're getting D, F, and A. And so on and so on. So that's what it's going to play if this chord pad is selected here. If I choose this one instead, then we get this very complex thing. If I play this one, then we're getting this played. Okay. And so the idea is you can record something. So try to come up with a progression that you like. So let's see, first of all, if I can get some kind of idea for progression. That's pretty nice. Okay, so let's just record that. So 1, 5, 3, 4. Okay, playing that back. I was a bit slow there, so let me press the record and go in quickly. Whoops. Okay, let's try again. Whoops, what did I do? 1, 3, 4, 5, wasn't it? No. 1. What did I do? 1, 5, 3, 4. Okay. So now we have also this evolve button. If I press evolve, it will just change the order of playback of these. It'll do it a bit randomly. So, by the way, if you turn evolve off, it will just play whatever the last evolved pattern was. There's no way to reset that. You'd have to record your individual pattern again, which I think is a pity. But this evolve feature is very nice, I think. I do really wish that the loop rate slider, instead of just being able to slow the playback of the loop down, I wish it could increase the rate, but it can't. I don't know why that's left out. That was left out in one of his recent apps as well, and I felt it was really a pity. But I could go in and play things quickly, but it would be difficult, maybe, you know. You'd have to practice. Especially if you're going to do something with a bit of intentionality. But, you know, part of the whole point of having MIDI things is that they sort of allow you to do things that would be hard for a human to do, like play very fast. And I think it's a real missed opportunity here that loop rate fader won't go up higher. You know, I'd like to be able to double the speed and have everything in between just one times and two times playback. But yeah, so the basic idea is, right, that you've played this in, and now you can go and you could change the root note, for example, right? Okay, or you could go through and pick these different modes and see how it feels. And you can change the chord shapes. Now, what's a huge pity, I think, is there's no preset system in this app. So if you come up with stuff that you like, there's just absolutely no way to save it. If you quit the app, when you open it up again, it will remember whatever settings it had last. So if you press play, it will play back whatever loop you recorded last. But why is there no preset system? I just don't understand why that is left out. I think it's a huge pity. So if you come up with something that you like in this app, you're absolutely gonna have to, you know, set up a piano roll app and record things into it and save them there. Bit of a pain in the ass, I think, to be honest. I really wish it had a preset system. Let's look at setup. So let's put this up again, so that we can send it out on those four channels. So rotate channels is off here. So it's randomizing what it sends them out to. If you look here, for example, you'll see this is not triggering with every note that's going out. It's only being triggered sometimes. If we turn on rotate channels, it seems like every note is going out on every channel, but I don't know, it will maybe be different on different passes of the loop or something, so that every time it loops round, it will actually sound a little bit different. Haven't really investigated that part in detail, but you can basically hear what's going on. It's bringing a bit of variety in. So I mean, another thing you can, you know, play around with this. So for example, you could just have channel one, or channel one and two. That's quite a nice thing to do, you know, vary things up in your performance. Lovely. And so here we have this random note delay. Apply random note delay not to 1 second. But really, I think it's a pity that it doesn't have its own ARP and strumming options in there. I guess you'll have to, you know, send the MIDI into something else that can allow you to do that, you know, just send it through an arpeggiator or whatever. But because it is a standalone app, it'd be nice if it had a bit more functionality built in, I think. Velocities, so we can send everything out on just one velocity, or we can set a few different velocities that we would like things to go out on. I kind of wish there was an option also to just set one main velocity and then have a knob that could set the potential range of deviation from that velocity. But this is a really... It's really a beautiful little app. I've been really enjoying playing around with it. So let me go through my criticisms. Let me just bring these up a little bit. So, some of these things I've mentioned already, some not. If you're finding this video useful, everyone, please smash the like, etc. And if you can, and if you're into this channel, if you would miss it if it wasn't here, please consider supporting me on Patreon or any of the other different ways that you can support, because I make almost nothing from YouTube ad revenue. It's just not feasible for me to continue doing this work without more support from developers and viewers. Thank you so much to those people who are supporting me. So, criticisms. Why only four savable chord shapes? Seems very small. I think at least eight would be good. It would really be an improvement. It would be more in line with other chord apps. Why no preset system? I just don't understand it. Most of this dev's apps have preset systems. Why does this not? All it would need is a button here. Presets, whatever, you tap that and it goes and opens up another screen. Absolutely bizarre to me that that's left out. As I mentioned a few times, why can the loop rate only slow down, not speed up? It's great that you can adjust the loop rate, but I'd really love to be able to speed it up. I'd really love that. It really bothers me that it doesn't have that. I've definitely missed that. It's not just a, you know, theoretical gripe. I've really felt the lack of it at times. What else? As I said, pity there are no inbuilt ARP settings or strum settings. It does have the option of the random note delay, which can be really, really nice, but definitely ARP and strum options I think would be great. As I said also, it's nice that you have a bit of control over velocity output, but I'd like it if we could set a main value and then use a knob to dial in the amount of deviation. Also, just to mention again what I said earlier in the video, this is limited to heptatonic modes, ones with seven notes, but I think that's totally understandable because of the UI architecture of the app. So you already do have a lot here. That's a really fun app. I mean, it's even if you don't know the first thing about music theory, I think you can come up with some lovely progressions here and then just play around with changing the modes and stuff, and suddenly you've got just a completely different flavor. Switch between the pads, and also just tweak these pads in real time. Just take one pad and just play around with that. It's absolutely beautiful. I always really enjoy this developer's apps. I do always have some criticisms about them, but I nevertheless do really enjoy them, I must say. Okay, everyone, thank you for watching. Hope you have a great day. Take it easy, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.